Beloveds, we have undergone unprecedented loss this year. 300,000 Americans, including some of our families and friends, have succumbed to death in this pandemic. Millions have lost economic security through loss of jobs or a stable income. Parents have become teachers at home, on top of trying to hold down their own jobs. People that have never before gone to food banks are now in long, long lines. Healthcare workers have risked their own lives for the sake of saving others. Many are homeless for the very first time this year. We have all lost something. We have lost our cherished rhythms of life that feel comfortable and familiar to us. We have even lost the beautiful ritual of being able to worship together in this sanctuary, in this very space together. And we can name far too many losses due to systemic racism and violence, and also those caused by fierce political division and disagreement. This has been a year like no other. Nonetheless, we, in the name of Jesus, we have proclaimed hope, love, joy, and peace in the midst of difficulty throughout this Advent season. This is the church's gift to the world. It's our gift to the world, that our faith story is grounded in the presence of God who came and dwelled among us in the midst of hardship, in the midst of challenge, in the midst of loss. But on this longest night, this winter solstice, it has become a tradition for us to honor the longest night of the year with a service to acknowledge our grief, our loneliness, and our sorrow, and to remember those and what we have lost. Let's be honest, sometimes hope, love, joy, and peace elude us when we have encountered so much loss and when we are mired in grief. Ritual helps us move through these feelings and funnel our heartbreak in ways that give space for tangible remembering. And tonight we give space for all that we need to grieve, even as we look towards Christmas Eve later this week. Tonight we honor the loss, the grief, and the sadness that we carry. Perhaps poet Mary Oliver said it best in these lines from her poem, The Uses of Sorrow. Someone I loved once gave me a box full of darkness. It took me years to understand that this too was a gift. Tonight we may gather in darkness, but we never lose sight of the light. The light of Christ that always is shining bright in our lives. Please join me in our call to worship. In the midst of excitement and bright lights, we feel the darkness of our souls. Come, God of power and light, hold us. Instead of gathering with loved ones this holiday season, we feel alone and isolated. Come, God of peace and hope, hear our cries. In the midst of celebration, our hearts cry out. Lord, hear us and come to us. Bring us peace. Amen.
Thank you.
us pray. Your compassion for us overflows, O God. We are facing our longest night. We come burdened with sorrow, loneliness, and loss. We come seeking a place to set them down, a place where our words will be heard and our feelings honored. We need space where we can drop our masks of good cheer so our tears can flow freely and our faces can wear the cares of all that we are carrying. Be among us this night, O God. Let your compassion heal us in this moment. Comfort us. Strengthen us. Care for us. Hold our grief. O come, Emmanuel, be Christ to us. Amen.
The scripture reading is Lamentations, chapter 3, verses 1 through 3, 19 to 26. I am someone who saw the suffering caused by God's angry rod. He drove me away, forced me to walk in darkness, not light. He turned his hand even against me over and over again, all day long. The memory of my suffering and homelessness is bitterness and poison. I can't help but remember and am depressed. I call all this to mind. Therefore, I will wait. Certainly the faithful love of the Lord hasn't ended. Certainly God's compassion isn't through. They are renewed every morning. Great is your faithfulness. I think, the Lord is my portion. Therefore, I'll wait for him. The Lord is good to those who hope in him, to the person who seeks him. It's good to wait in silence for the Lord's deliverance. Here ends the reading from God's Word. Thanks be to God who is still speaking.
A litany for losses. On the shortest day of the year, as we head into the longest night, we gather, mindful of the losses that have multiplied throughout this unforgettable year. As we look back at it all at once, we are in danger of being overwhelmed by its tragedies. Sickness, death, violence, natural disasters, and more. Our aim tonight is to acknowledge this, to mourn this, and to know that in all of this, there is the possibility of more light. If we are to be overwhelmed, let it be that we are overwhelmed with the assurance that we are not alone. We are able to do this because the longest night is the birth canal for the ever more light as the days now lengthen and we wait for the new springtime of new life. Some of our earliest evidence is that our ancient ancestors saw this night and the dawn of tomorrow as the appropriate time to honor their lost loved ones. It was this moment that symbolized most powerfully that the path to everlasting life is filled with the light of a new and growing dawn. Psalm 36:9 says, "Within you is the spring of life. In your light, we see light." As I light this candle, though its light is as blue as many of us feel, the light is still there. When we feel as if our light is dimmed, we can rely on the holy light to continue to shine until we ourselves shine bright once more. We are not alone.
In our pain, our blue, our beautiful, our hard, our messy, our ugly, our struggles and our joys. God is with us. God accompanying us. God alongside us. God amid us. God among us. God beside us. Including us, God near us, God plus us, God upon us, God as companion to us, God side by side us, God in the thick of our humanity, in the middle of this weary world. Is with us in the gift and in the muck and mire of real life. We are called to be present, to be in the flesh with one another, accompanying others, alongside others, amid others, beside others, by others, for including others, near others, a companion to others, side by side with others, in the thick of others. God with us, us with others, God with the world in the thick of the beautiful and the messy.
Please join us in a litany of losses. We mourn this night the loss of life. For so many, the pandemic has taken loved ones. We mourn the loss of those close to us and those whose names we do not know. We mourn those who perished while working to save the lives of others. We mourn those who died, not of pandemic, but of other causes. And we mourn the loss, in many cases, of our ability to be with them as they passed, and our loss of gathering together for comfort in the ways we needed so much. I invite you to repeat after me. We mourn the loss of life. We honor and remember these beloveds. We pray for comfort and peace. Amen.
We mourn this night the loss of livelihoods. For so many, the pandemic has taken the security of food, shelter, care for families, and medical care. We mourn the loss of businesses that could not withstand the circumstances. These were not just businesses, but dreams born of passion and hard work. We mourn those who find themselves needing to rely on others for help when what they really want to do is to be able to help others. I invite you to repeat after me. We mourn this loss of livelihood. We mourn this loss of livelihood. We honor and remember the dreams now deferred. We honor and remember the dreams now deferred. We pray for sustenance and resilience. We pray for sustenance and resilience. Amen.
We mourn this night the loss of love. Our society's dilemma, centuries in the making, has created such hatred, suffering, oppression, and ill will. We mourn the loss of those whose lives were lost to brutality and violence. We mourn the loss of our ability to love one another despite our differences as beings who deserve to be seen for our inherent beauty and worth. We mourn the black and brown peoples have perished and suffered as the greatest proportion in the pandemic of coronavirus. We mourn the pandemic of racism that still plagues the fabric of our communities. I invite you to repeat after me. We mourn this loss of love. We mourn this loss of love. We honor and remember the work of prophets who proclaim justice. We honor and remember the work of prophets who proclaim justice. We pray for compassion and change. We pray for compassion and change. Amen.
We mourn this night the loss of liveliness. For so many, this year has robbed us of our energy, our enthusiasm, and our sense of well-being. We mourn teachers, caregivers, pastors, and healthcare workers who are struggling to help those in their care, themselves exhausted and needing the sustenance they give to others. We mourn the loss of all who are suffering with anxiety and depression, who are finding it difficult to live each day with fullness or to find hope for tomorrow. We mourn those we have lost to suicide. We mourn those who find themselves addicted to substances in order to ease the pain that feels unbearable. We mourn those who are experiencing their place of shelter as an abusive place from which they struggle to escape. I invite you to repeat after me. We mourn this loss of liveliness. We mourn this loss of liveliness. We honor and remember that each person is precious and whole. We honor and remember that each person is precious and whole. We pray for recovery and renewed vigor. We pray for recovery and renewed vigor. Amen.
I took my tree down to the shore, the garland and the silver star, to find my peace and grieve no more. to heal this place inside my heart. On every branch I laid some bread, and hungry birds filled up the sky. They rang like bells around my head. They sang my spirit back to life. One tiny child can change the world. One shining light can show the way. Still my joy for Christmas Day. The snow comes down on empty sand. There's tinsel moonlight on the waves. My soul was lost, but here I am. The amazing grace. One tiny child can change the world. One shining light can show the way. Beyond my tears for what I've lost, there's still my joy. There's still my joy for Christmas Day.
And now we light one more candle, just as we will do later this week on Christmas Eve. We light this as a sign of our hope and of our belief. We believe in the light that has come and is coming. This light casts its glow on all the surrounding prayers we have prayed. This light resides within us, perhaps dim for a time, but always lit, an ember of the holy inside us. This light reminds us that we are not alone. Hear once again these words of poet Mary Oliver. Someone I loved once gave me a box full of darkness. It took me years to understand that this too was a gift.
Edna Harth. Donna Snyder. Cindy Simons. Mary Alice Bulletin. Peter Kletzian. Bob Stevenson. Franklin Smith. Theda Mason. Robert Montgomery. Helen Sinclair. Jug Reitinger. Fritz Barker. Paul Statler. Jane Horke. Ralph Quellhorst. Colleen McGraw. Richard Buckley. Arthur Wells. Sonia Caro. Bob Horner. Arthur Frisbee. Donna Hall. Rita McGinty. Ellen Smith. Janet Shanley. Dorothy Rainier.
Beloveds of God, go now in peace. Go knowing that God, whose love created the world, sent Jesus into this same world to be our friend, our companion, and Savior, and who claimed, "Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted." The light shines in the darkness, yes, but the darkness will never, ever overcome it. Amen.